via win eventually last weekend, ensuring that they claim the 3 points. Need a third win of the season.
Absolutely, only their third win in 11 games. You would expect better from Orlando Pirates.
Mistake there from Tyler. Immediately putting his team under pressure as he apologizes to his teammates. Urged on there. I don't know if you can pick it up on the audio mics by his captain, Marcus Leckie. Concentration in the early stages of this game is going to be crucial, Grant. You don't want to be letting your opponents in very early. There goes the team talk out of the window.
Well, Twyla did endeavor to make amends for his mistake. Was upon the Pirates player as quick as he possibly could be after having lost out.
Roger Machafa, the Orlando Pirates skipper. Good for the likes of Lebo Senso. Quick clip, had a short free kick. Intricate, but not intricate enough for the clever boys. More to feed to Mashangu. The knee turn, but the pass was rather untidy. I was going to say, Grant, two names for Bitvest Wits that pop out. Aquelius Masuku and Musia Kaka. They're not here.
Well, that was exactly the thoughts on my mind. I'll add another one to it. Sekese.
Get back to the point as Amiko Memela. What a name. Tries to slip through a ball to the man Mashangu. He seems to be going to be the focal point of this game. Now here comes Cesar Twala. Does well to beat one, beat two. Surrounded by Pirates players. It's too well to retain the ball. As soon as I say that, they lose it.
Masuku looked so good 2 weeks ago at the Comfort Stadium. Playing against Kaizer Chiefs, so composed on the ball. He's a big, powerful presence as well. Much smaller midfield being utilized today. Jacobs, Van Heerden, Jordan. Sekese not part of that midfield either.
Now here comes Amigo Memel. A lot of space, a lot of time. A lot of air on that cross. Interesting, according to the team sheets, Lebo Senso, the former skipper for Pirates, is playing at center back. By the looks of it, is pushed further field. More an attacking position.
Now, Vono gets a touch here. And it's interesting to note, Temba, I was wondering how long I would keep this in my back pocket.
Now, here comes Mukasi, fresh off. Spectacular goal. Ikamva certainly can strike a ball. Punished from a similar position. Absolute rocket.
Well, Mpanjwa holds that one, which is something Navona was not able to do the last time he faced Bidvest Wits. Of course, I'm referring to when he started between the sticks in the APSA Premiership. You might remember that game. Wits up against Orlando Pirates. It's a game that ended 1-0. Avona will he'll want to forget that one as quick as possible, dropping it over the line to give Wits a victory in a game in which they went down to 9 men. So against this team, he'll be hoping that history doesn't repeat itself.
Khanyamani there having an opportunity to impress Peruvian Gustavo Palacios, who's tried a lot of combinations, trying to find a lot of combinations. Now here come Amapagania with Mokasi, who spots Mashangu's run. Good intent shown by the Orlando Pirates left winger. He's found opportunities limited, but whenever he's come off the bench, he's been quite impressive. Changed the game around on his head when he came off the bench. In Ikamva, as we mentioned, bagged a goal in that game as well. Seen he has edged out the likes of Neo Marks. In terms of a starting position. Palacios will be looking for goals from the likes of Amigo Memela. try to regather the ball very spectacularly. Perhaps the pass just a slightly overcooked there. Not enough goals coming from this Orlando Pirates outfit, the likes of Roger Machafa and the likes of Menzi Masuku. Whenever he's in the mix, haven't been able to find the back of the net with regularity. Mutsehwa, Jackie Mutsehwa, experienced Jackie Mutsehwa, Mapaganea's top goal scorer with 2 goals, shows you the sort of lack of goal draw. So a lot of players, Roger Machafa, Moses Mukasi, that man Mashangu, is playing striker for Pirates today. Really need to be upping their levels in terms of the goals to game ratio.
Well, the goal output hasn't been good, but Roger Machafa did get himself on the score sheet last time out as Pirates triumphed 1-0 of the Free State Stars. So he'll be hoping to just build on that.
These little other 1-2 between Senzo Mukhanyamani, who's past the early run of Mashangu. Crosses the ball there, perhaps without looking and getting his head up. Nasi does ever so well to win a corner for his team, showed his pace. Moses Mukasi, she did mention the youngster will be looking to impress Augusto Palacios. He's still searching for the winning formula, as we did mention. So the Pirates youngsters have an opportunity to unhinge the locked smiles of the happy people out of the much anticipated derby today. Ball in for Mashangu. Improvised. Neat little healer, but not enough power. Pace now on the far side. Anwaba Mnisi showing a clean pair of heels. A lot of space to work in. Liam Jordan. Rather, it's Marcus Lecky. Mukasi, they're winning the header, but only one man to aim for Mashangu. No midfield runs there from the likes of Mkonza. Malinga, 18-year-old central defender. Now here come the clever boys. But their man Mnisi. The defender, the Pirates counter attacking opportunity. Amigo Memela. Well, time run. Spoke too early. Shangu ran too early. Good spot though from Amigo Memela. Shangu availing himself, but on that instance couldn't curb his run and time it to perfection. But he's tried that run on a number of occasions now. Sbu Mashangu, the 21-year-old, formerly of Randburg FC. Time for Liam Jordan. Rushed by Mukhanyamani. Does well to beat his man as Twalas gives it back to Jordan with a snapshot. Shown there by Pirates to get the ball out, but in the end they lose it. Mashangu, there's touch letting him down. That man Mkonza doing the dirty work, sweeping. Time and space. Not enough options in the box, not enough bodies in the box. Sees a twirl and Kachani were in the box there, but not found. Yamuse. Yamuse.
And what a good weekend this could be for the Buccaneers if they can get a win here and then get a win later this afternoon. It's the big one. That's the best way to spend a Saturday afternoon, isn't it?
Now Makasi leaving the ball behind. He had one space and time as Morse shows off his composure. Well defended in the end.
Crowd certainly appreciating that one. A big roar went up.
Konza spots Mukasi again.
Linesman spots that he's offside.
A big diagonal ball now. They tried it three or so times now. Grant, clear tactic, get the ball to Mukasi. Moses Mukasi is quite a direct player, likes running a player, cutting in onto his favorite right foot and unleashing thunderbolts from those yellow boots of his. Liam Jordan surrounded by Pirates players, showing his composure, showing a bit of skill, receives the return ball. Jordan, confident man, did mention he's got on the score sheet as a ball comes in for Twala. Missed time and space. Bundled off the ball. Referee says penalty. Luyalo Mjezu. Mukhanyamani remonstrating with the referee there. Remonstrating his innocence. So if it's a contact sport, referee says final decision, penalty. London Pirates under pressure early on, Grant. And a yellow card for his troubles.
And a huge amount of pressure now. Unsure of whether he talked his way into the book or if that yellow card is for the infringement. Just moments before that, it obviously incurred the penalty. It will be Liam Jordan to take, standing over this one. He has scored three goals this season. Scored last time out in the 90th minute, adding to two that he had got from set pieces. One, in fact, was from the penalty spot. So a chance to get his fourth and put a second in the back of the net from 12 yards out.
Filippo Vono versus Liam Jordan. Is it Jordan or Vono? Liam Jordan steps up. Saved by Vono! Rebound back of the net. Unlucky there from Filippo Vono. The initial save. Did well to keep it out of his goals, but parried it back onto the unrushing Liam Jordan. Perhaps when you're confident, luck is there for you. He hits a bit of a dab there.
These youngsters obviously in touch with the trendy dance moves.
An opportunity there as we see the slow-mo. Moriane, the man adjusted to have been fouled by Mukhanyamani. Liam Jordan misses the ensuing spot kick. Vono saves. We need to see the ball sail back to the back of the net.
Well, Vono was furious afterwards, just kicking the ball away in frustration. Whether he was furious with himself or just furious with his bad luck, which again comes against Bidvest Wits, I'm not too sure of, but absolutely incensed.
Grand referee Loyolo Mjezu now in the spotlight. The team in black would be saying that that is not a penalty. The team in white would be saying thank you very much.
Moriani let the ball run away from him slightly, but there was certainly contact. Whether it was just a coming together or not.
Roger Majafa with a short one. Mukasi was the target. Yeah, shot in the end for him. Tried that twice now, that little move clearly from the training ground. Now the mental capacity, the ability to fight, that fire deep down in the belly will be tested. These young men from Orlando have often just crumbled when the going gets tough. And there's quite a young and new team that Augusto Palacio has assembled, Grant.
Well, there's a young team. We've seen them employ some of the old guard. Well, I wouldn't quite say old guard, but some of their younger first teamers in the MDC setup, the likes of Masuku. Not available today. Will we see him later on as part of the 18 for the derby or not?
Enterprising play from Orlando Pirates, trying to respond in kind. Great little touches to build up to that shot from Lebusenso. Doing ever so well to build up and get, or manufacture rather, a shooting opportunity.
Coming back to someone like Masuku, who we expect to see at least featuring, or at least on the bench today, later on. Will he now be able to put his hand up following the departure of Kermit Erasmus and say, give me one of those attacking spots on a more permanent basis? He'll need to do better than he has been doing in the MDC. Had a blistering run last season where Orlando Pirates finished top of their group. It hasn't quite come off for him so far in 2015-2016.
There's an opportunity there for Lindsay Masuku. Sudden departure, as you did say, of that man Kermit Erasmus. And talent being lost to the Ligue 1.
Will now be applying his trade in France, Stade Rennais.
See, you worked on your French there.
That was terrible. Rennais, I think.
Now Luciano van Heerden looking for Mose. Spots around, but couldn't find Katane. For a second there, Marcus Lecky looked like he had put himself under pressure. Pressure coming from Mahlangu. Lovely ball. No cushioned header from Twala. Not enough pressure from Orlando Pirates. He is rather walking. Sort of putting the lights over. Sifiso Mabanga and the captain Marcus Lecky. Liam Jordan looking for options now. Finds an option. Shot! That worked. Sifiso Twala in the end. The man found himself in a shooting position. A nice piece of play there from the clever boys.
The 18-year-old from Naledi just having to dig that out from under his feet, but tried to bend it into the top corner. Ivona showing a good pair of hands there.
And we did mention the departures from Orlando Pirates. Well, Vitz is also, the senior team has also been making, they've also rather dipped into the transfer market. Coach Gavin Hunt is saying that his business is done after securing the signature of AmaZulu defender Sifiso Santi, among others. Jokingly said a couple of departures are on the cards and the incomings are done. And saying he's jokingly possible departures in his team. Maybe looking at getting Leo Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo into his team. Good luck with that one. Cross now into the box. Shot for Van Heerden. Air shot. Ball still in the danger zone for Orlando Pirates, but in the end, well controlled by Filippo Ovono. Pirates slightly edging possession stats. But game of football is not just one on stats. One stat that does count the most, that wins you games, that wins you championships, are goals. That man, Mukhanyamani, will probably still be thinking about that decision against him and the yellow card. And was penalized for a penalty. Now penalized for a foul throw. Not a good day for Mukhanyamani at the office this far.
Hasn't been great for him. It's been a good day for Liam Jordan. I'm not just talking about the penalty, which of course he didn't manage to put in the back of the net. Only on the second time of asking. Well, did it bulge the net, but he hasn't really put a foot wrong. Despite that, passing been crisp, purposeful, positive, and he showed some great touches, great skills. You were talking about Gavin Hunt wanting to draft in the likes of Cristiano Ronaldo. We've seen him, Liam Jordan, score from one of those knuckleball free kicks. We've seen good skill. Perhaps he's a mini version there.
We have seen some outstanding pieces of free kick work. Liam Jordan, Spencer Mande, some of the top free kick takers in MDC. You mentioned a keyword, positive, Grant. Polokwane City players have just walked past our commentary box and some good positive body language coming from them. They're happy, they just won. Now I can sit back and enjoy, watch the likes of Moses Mukasi toil in the sun of PE.
Well, they toiled in the sun long and hard for 1.5 hours and they got a just reward. Now is their time to relax and enjoy some football. A lot of smiles, especially for a couple of selfies that are being taken. Let's look on Instagram later, because I think we were in the background, actually.
It's interesting to see. Get back to that point as Mahlangu does ever so well to turn and spot the run. But man, Amigo Memela, he's looked the brightest spark thus far for Amapagania. Him on the right-hand side and Moses Mukasi on the other side. Hasn't quite yet sparked into a concrete opportunity for Pirates. Disappointing attempted pass there. Katani makes a run off screen, but Ngoba Mnisi decides to go back and restart again. Grant, I'm so interested to see some of the individual battles, the likes of the man Moses Mukasi up against Mose Ngoba Mnisi, while Liam Jordan particularly would be catching the attention of Roger Machafa at midfield battle. The man, just speaking about Liam Jordan, be looking to impose himself against this London Pirates midfield. Great run there from Muriani. The back post not spotted as Wirtz come again. And Ngoba Mnisi overcooks his attempted cross. Looks of it, Liam Jordan took a knock to the face. Seems okay to continue. His game has improved as MDC has gone on. Remember seeing him at Makulong and was absolutely overpowered on the day. As I think was subbed off in the latter stages of the game. But he's grown from strength to strength. Now an integral member of this Clever Boys side. Shangu beats one man. Has to go back. Doesn't spot an option in the box. Crowded out our London Pirates and eventually lose out. Good defending. Told you the Swiss side is a hard-working unit. Been unspectacular at times, but they've been consistent, find themselves at sixth position.
Well, speaking of being in fairly lofty positions on the league table after game week 4, Orlando Pirates were in 5th and would have been hoping to continue to push onwards and upwards. It hasn't panned out that way. They've spent a long, long time in the bottom half of the table, just not able to show any consistency, and do often fall foul of some pretty hefty scorelines as well.
Never did recover from their opening day defeat to Amatax. It's been sort of a stuttering season for the man in black. Nonetheless, today they have an opportunity. Today is a new day, a new challenge. And as we did say, they would like to start Derby Day proceedings with a smile on the happy people's faces. Perhaps the smile has turned to a frown of late. But the youngsters, like the Moses Mukasi, the man on the ball, have an opportunity to prove their worth.
Mahlangu under that one, but in the end he was never going to get enough power on it to test the keeper, unless he was somehow able to loop it over him. Would have been better served to try and knock it back across the box, make something happen.
Moses Mukasa, the man now, is just on the ball, seems to have swapped sides. He's more now on the right-hand side. He's actually been good on the left-hand side. Perhaps feeling his mojo might just be more productive on the right-hand side, swapping flanks with Amigo Memela. Yes, Mangoba Mnisi puts the Pirates defenders under pressure. Lechaba, Kamu Lechaba, a 19-year-old. Had to be about his wits there. Great run there from Amigo Memela. Attempted pass by Lewu Senso in the end. Couldn't find him. But he did spot him. Grantham looking up now. Whenever the Pirates midfielders or fullbacks look up, it's about 7-8 jerseys surrounding about 3 Pirates players. Hence they keep hitting these big diagonal balls and hoping perhaps to start an attack from there.
Well, Lekki and Mabunga pretty good under the high ball, as you saw Mabunga there. Yes, it's gone out for a corner.
Kasi puts in. Now swinger.
But he did make the necessary intervention. They've been really decent, and it doesn't look like Pirates are going to be able to get the better of them whilst employing these tactics that they are doing so currently.
Did mention the likes of Marcus Lekki, Sifiso Mabanga. They've been putting on pressure on the likes of Bongani Kumalo. He's just joined the ranks of the clever boys.
We've got a feel for someone like Lekki. He's a pretty, a very talented player, as is Mabanga. And with more centre-halves, more central defenders joining the ranks of Bukvis, but it's going to be harder and harder for them to crack the team.
Competition always gets the best out of certain players. Here come Amigo Memela. Great all-time tackle in the end by the man in short, Musa. Well, I beg your apologies, Sifiso Mabanga. Really a problem there, and a necessary problem for Bidvisvit. But in the end, Mabanga read it well. Now Moriena looking up, spotting the run of Liam Jordan. Couldn't control. See the difference between Vitz and Orlando Pirates. Whenever Vitz have the ball, the players seem to be get back to that opportunity. Comes in right from there, because they're able to interchange and pass each other, find each other. That's the key word. They've been able to fashion chances like that, where Cesar Twala in that instance just swung his left foot, his weaker left foot at it. The Pirates look up. Not enough players close enough to Mahlangu.
Well, it came upon him really quickly there, Twala, and had a go at it, but just with a swinger, with his standing foot, not able to direct it in on goal. But it was such a neat touch by Jordan to set him up. Showed great presence of mind.
Lovely piece of skill there by Mahlangu, 21-year-old. Liam Jordan with his own piece of skill. Step over here, stop over there. Beats his man on the outside, gets a cross in. Dali there was bamboozled and bedazzled there. Liam Jordan is having a good game, Grant.
He's having
absolutely everywhere. Sorry there.
Sorry there, you're having a really, really good game and operating in so many different positions. Started very centrally.
Now here come the clever boys. It sees a Twala, great tackle.
Well, it is Twala that seems to have switched with him. Jordan now operating on the left. And he seems to be very, very two-footed. Of course, had to follow up his missed penalty with his left foot. Delivered a great cross in just now with his left foot. And, of course, very competent with his right as well.
showing some dexterity.
And showing why a year or two ago he was included in a top 100 young players of the world to watch. He was our South African entry. Quite an honor for the young man. And proving that he could go on to pretty great things.
Linga, the man who was just in shot briefly, getting some attention. Seemed to have gotten a knock to his eye. Nonetheless, play continues without him. I mentioned a lot of talent coming through the ranks of South African football, similar to Liam Jordan, as Godinho, SuperSport United defender, won a competition to get to Brazil. Actually stayed there, but I think problems with his passport or so, his trip had to be cut short. Moses Mukasi and Roger Majafa pondering and plotting. They need some sort of magic to get themselves back in this game. Looks of it, Mukasi seems the man with the most intent etched on his face. His body language anyway. This referee, Loloyo Mchezu. Opportunity comes in, wasteful in the end. Moses Mukasi, better than that, we have seen. His technique is absolutely impeccable at times.
Saw it on display in Cape Town, of course. It'll be hard to forget the goal that he scored against Platinum Stars, and a game that they did go on to lose, however.
Grant, that man in short, Roger Machafa, who's doing a bit of defensive work. He's been anonymous in this game. He's the captain, he's the skipper, leading by example. He's been absolutely outplayed by the trio of Liam Jordan, Keegan Jacobs, and Luciano van Heerden. He's a trial as well, coming deeper. I think you are right. I think you are right, Grant. We'll see. Twala and Liam Jordan clearly have done a positional change.
Twala does seem to be back out on the flank. Jordan more central. In fact, if anything, he switched right, just giving everyone something to think about. Very good with the ball at his feet.
Need the interplay to change the point of attack for the clever boys. Bit of work there from Moriene. Defended there, Mavhoyamani. Senso and does all that good work from the left back. Liam Jordan found well by the pass and fouled. This is Liam Jordan territory, Grant.
This is where he likes to take them from. Would have preferred, I'm sure, to get the shot away there. Made himself space brilliantly, twisting and turning. And now, as you'll see here, very comfortable to go onto his left foot. Many players would try and engineer space for their stronger foot. He's happy to go the way that's more favorable in terms of creating an advantage for himself. And now, he will have an opportunity from quite close in. In fact, if anything, it's a little too close for him.
It's also Lord, the pass that got him in that position. Absolutely rifled at him, and he did well to take a first touch, turn back onto his left foot. It must be quite difficult, a nightmare to mark a person who's good with their left and right, i.e. Cristiano Ronaldo.
Cesar Twala seems to be interested in this one. I mentioned that especially with Liam Jordan's technique, the knuckleball, a very flat free kick that needs to get up and over the wall quickly, it's difficult.
Cesar Twala now with an opportunity. Strikes the wall and nothing comes of it. and comes from that ensuing spot kick.
Claiming that the wall encroached on that 10-yard space that should have been between him and the wall.
See Zutala there with the free kick opportunity to put the put in. Did mention, lovely young man as well, of the pleasure of having a chat with him, mentioning his rise through the ranks at Wits as well, saying if he did not play football, starting along the lines of engineering and such. It's good to see that footballers think outside the box, outside the pitch. Life after football, it is a short career in some instances.
It was really good to see how many of these young men have just matriculated. 2015 matriculants. And how many of them indeed are actually studying, currently juggling football and their studies.
Amigo Memela is absolutely fizzing through the middle there in between Moriene and Marcus Lackey. Pass was stopped though. Shangu has done a lot of running in the last few minutes. His runs haven't been as purposeful, haven't been as productive as in the opening few minutes of the game. Now here comes Mkonza, who spots Lechaba. He's opted for that ball a few times in that instance, nearly finds it. That man, Mashangu, who's a likely target because he's the tallest player in amongst attacking unit for London Pirates today. Often is the tallest player. Next of Neil Marks is on the bench. Absolute small men as compared to him. An opportunity now for Katani. Battling away but crowded out in the end. Lebo Sento with a good looking ball to find his man. Mukasi one on one. Mukasi did mention he likes to cut in on that favorite right foot of his. Second time now he scuffed his shot.
Perhaps envisioning it flying into the top right-hand corner as it did 2 weeks ago. Didn't come off for him though. On the other side, before that very, very quick break, Catania doing pretty well. Stayed strong. Could have gone down a number of times actually under pressure. But chose to stay on his feet.
An opportunity now, Katani. Spots Mnisi. Bombing forward is Mose. Looks up. Opts to give it to Mnisi again, who sees the run of Van Heerden and Jordan, who had been running to the same space.
Good covering tackle there by Lechaba. Jordan almost seemed to be caught in two minds there, but was waiting for the tackle or waiting for some kind of challenge. Would react from it, and he has won a corner which he'll now deliver.
Liam Jordan looking for the options of Leki. Couldn't beat the first man in their post there. Just thinking of Mukasi and his approach thus far in this game, the left winger for Orlando Pirates. He's tried that cutting in, as we often see players, modern day players nowadays, wingers come strikers cutting in to their preferred strong feet and having a go, having a pot shot. Perhaps he's tried the three times, why not try perhaps a step over and take your opponent to the byline and get across him. Only problem, Mashangu is the only man to aim for, as it's often been the case in the first half. If you've just walked in, London Pirates find themselves under the cosh yet again this season. How many times have we said this season for the man from Soweto? Clever boys in this instance, ensuring that they take the lead through somewhat, some may say, a debatable penalty. There's nothing debatable about Liam Jordan's finish. Filippo Vono did save it, but the ensuing rebound, he did put it in the back of an empty net. Hence we find ourselves at 1-0. Now here comes Amigo Memela. Where are his options in the box? We've been saying not enough options in the box. Hence he had to try take Marcus Lecky along the line and beat him for pace rather than look up and put a ball of quality in. It was only Mkhonzi in the box there, Grant.
Well, Lecky did well. He was beaten for pace and managed to recover at the expense of a corner.
Mukasi, ball of quality. Can he put it in? Doesn't necessarily hit any particular target. Pirates being pushed back from that corner. It's going to be an interesting half-time chat from Augusto Palacios. His team have had half chances, really, have not created anything clear-cut for the likes of Mahlangu. Amigo Memela from the right-hand side, he's been productive, he's been dynamic. Locals enjoying their football. I'm glad they seem to found some shade, rather. Unlucky for those fans. But nonetheless, the football has been exciting here. Ipai, the friendly city. Locals are a friendly bunch. As Grant Bissett would attest to.
We've had a warm welcome from the Windy City.
Well, Glenn Salmon, Grant, presume he'll be the calm of the two, the easier in terms of the feeling of his charges. It's gone well for him. I think he'll take what he's seen today. It's unnecessarily known for the free-flowing attacking football. They are a hard-working team with quality from the wings and the center, like in the likes of Liam Jordan and Aquilius Masuku, who's not here. An opportunity now for Mahlangu. Several times the tactic Pirates has used has not come to fruition thus far. Perhaps a change of tactic. Not quite sure, hence I'm not a coach. It's a difficult job, an unforgiving one.
Hear word from the touchline that there will be 1 minute at a time. One more minute for Bidvest Wits to just see out. They'll want to go into the break. A goal up. Of course, if the score remained the same, that would mean that they remain unbeaten in 2016.
Luciano van Heerden. Lovely little back heeler for the on-rushing Manqoba Mnisi. Loses out. Roger Majafa now being pushed back. But does well to spot Amigo Memela, who was in space and did well to turn. Mukhanyamani with a lot of space. Mukasi, the onrushing. Memela had continued his run. Mabanja, had come out. Nearly one of the most freaky, lucky goals you've ever seen at MCC.
Oh, it would have been bizarre if this has gone in the back of the net. The keeper certainly had a right to come for it, but it's closed down so quickly. And if you put that effort in, well, you could get rewarded, and they almost were there, Orlando Pirates.
With that, referee Luyolo Mchezu calls it quits for the first half. Liam Jordan, the man who was just in picture there, putting the clever boys ahead in the first 45. Filippo Vono hasn't really had a lot of work to do other than the penalty. Vets as well, although they're leading, haven't created too many clear-cut chances, but they've seen the more likeliest to score between the two. That man Mabanja, short while ago, nearly conceding one of the most stranger goals if it went in. But he keeps his clean sheet at halftime. London Pirates with it all to do. Bidvest Wits find themselves leading in 15th minute. Liam Jordan with the penalty. And then from the ensuing penalty, finished it. At half time, it's 1-0 to Wits, 0 to Orlando Pirates.
Thank you, commentary team. The super voices of Asidali, Temba Boy, alongside Grant Spitz. It's Bidwest Wits who lead up against Orlando Pirates in the first half. We got a tweet here from Ed Seluleko saying, commentators are grooming so well under this program. I'm wishing you all the best. Thanks to MultiChoice. Hashtag Asidali. Continue sending us those tweets using the hashtag Asidali. It is 1-0 to Bidwest. Bidwest Wits in the first half against Orlando Pirates. Stay tuned for the second half coming up after this.
Back again at Wilson Stadium. The clever boys have been too clever in the first half for Orlando Pirates. In the 15th minute, we've just got in your living room and are watching some of the highlights. An opportunity for Bidwest Wits. Referee Luyolo Mjezu coming in and saying that's a penalty. Mukhanyamane, the left back for Orlando Pirates, getting a yellow card for that tackle and conceding a penalty to which Filippo Vono wants to save it. First half, but rebound, Liam Jordan, easy pickings in the end. His second goal in two games. Was advantage of it in that instance, Grant?
Well, it was, and they kept pushing forward. We would have thought that Orlando Pirates would have been seeing more of it as they searched for a way back into this. Twala just skying that as Liam Jordan touched it back neatly to him.
This game has been an enthralling one. Orlando Pirates, though, perhaps not being the sharper of the two when it comes to chances, have created not a lot, really. Bedford Smith dominating possession. The midfield has been crucial. Nkonza Mahlangu need to up their game. Liam Jordan, Keegan Jacobs dominating them. On the right-hand side for Bedford Smith, it's been Manqoba Mnisi bombing down the right-hand side with Morse in attendance in the midfield of the Orlando Pirates, losing that battle, as I did mention. Liam Jordan running riot, really. Orlando Pirates, quick look at their bench. Neil Marks is a name that pops up at you. Perhaps an opportunity for coach Palacios to throw him in.
Thank you, commentary team. The first half has certainly been enthralling between Bedford Vets and Orlando Pirates. Joining me right now is MEC of Sports and Recreation, PE, Dr. Pemi Majorina. Doctor, thank you so much for your time. Once again, the multi-choice Disky Challenge comes to PE.
We are very much excited to the viewers at home. We are saying, as I said it in November, when I was in Gauteng, I said, come to Eastern Cape, we're going to show you what does soccer means to us. It is a very exciting moment. As you can see, the attendance is beautiful. And I'm saying to all the players, that let them discover their potential today. Here is a game, here is a stadium. We are here to support them.
You talk about a great turnout. You guys never disappoint when we come to PE.
Yes, this is the home of legends. We're legends in each and everything, be it sport, be it arts, be it culture. And our people are very thirsty for such games. And we are very much thankful to Disky Challenge for bringing this particular game here to PE.
You guys are very big on sports.
We are, as I speak to you now, we're hosting EP Rugby AGM. We'll be hosting the Super Rugby. We'll be hosting the PSL teams. And this is just vibe in the Eastern Cape.
Dr. Pemi, thank you so much for your time. Enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you very much. Keep on developing grassroots soccer. And we are really going to support you and move behind you all the time.
Thank you. That is MEC of Sports and Recreation and PE, Dr. Pemi Majoran. Talk to us on social media using the hashtag Asidali. We've been trending for 2 hours. Continue sending us those tweets. Stay tuned to your World of Champions. The second half is coming up after this break.
back at Wilson Stadium. Sisepa, as we mentioned, small matter of a derby to come straight after this. But we're in the here, we're in the now. Second half about to start again. Pit vs Pit in the pound seats. Second 45 to start. Can Orlando Pirates find the answers? Let's find out together. As the referee Luyolo Mchezu gets play underway in the second stanza. Ambitious shot there. I think it was Roger Majafa from the center circle. That means Puma Shangu was subbed at halftime. Letsi Kwapeng taking his position up front now. Is this the first start of his? Or rather, his first start in MDC, should I rather say. Letsi Kwapeng. Surprised by the change. Puma Shangu was quite industrious in the first half. Put himself about. Quite difficult because he didn't have a lot of service coming into feet, or a lot of the play was to the head, very aerial. It was quite cynical. Goalkeeper they impeded as referee Luyolo Mchezu speaks to Marcus Slecky. He has a laugh with the referee. Nothing funny about getting a yellow card now. The referee did not find that one funny.
Speaking to Marcus Leckie. Marcus Leckie did some speaking of his own. Talked his way into the book. Don't want your centre half to have picked up a card. He'll be walking on eggshells for the rest of this game.
Unnecessary pressure. He's found himself now under. Marcus Leckie. As we did mention, Pirates have made a sub up front. From a first perspective, the likes of Sumelo Ntsundwa and then Thokozisi Hlambule on the bench for them as an opportunity for Orlando Pirates. Letsi Kwapeng laid it on for the onrushing Amigo Memela. He's been productive. The likeliest scorer for Pirates, judging by his first half performance. As we did mention, that man who just came on, Letsi Kwapeng, laid it off for Amigo Memela, could not keep his shot down in the end. Early chance though for Pirates in the second half.
Well, they would have no doubt got an absolute tongue lashing from Augusto Palacios. And they've come out showing some intent in the second half.
You're gonna need to turn intent into efficiency, Grant. Letsi Kwapeng putting Mabanjwa under pressure.
So Mabanjwa under pressure in the first half almost resulted in the strangest of own goals. Well, not really an own goal. Would have been credited to the player, of course. So they need to be careful with that. Taking a little bit too long at the back.
Now Roger Machafa spotting a run. They made by Amigo Memela. The obstacle to Lebusento was under pressure, quickly closed down, but Roger Majafa still with the ball playing. Need 1-2. Lebusento lines up a shot. Turned at space. And you did mention that keyword intent. It was an intentful shot there.
Good shape on it, just unlucky to see it go over the bar.
Pirates are creating the chances. Perhaps not efficient enough and not getting them on target. Hence, they're not reaping the rewards of perhaps a spillage from the keeper like we saw from the Witzer goal. Vono spilling it. And Liam Jordan coming in and putting the ball in an empty net, Grant.
Well, absolutely. I mean, in terms of hitting the target, Witz doing it 66% of the time or so. And Orlando Pirates, only just over 15% accuracy. It's just not really good enough at all.
I'm not quite interested. I'd love to be a fly on the wall of Orlando Pirates dressing room. What the thinking was, what Letsi Kwapeng would have been giving, that Spuma Hlangu wasn't. In the first instance, nearly had an assist early on for Amigo Memela. Corner can't quite even. Both teams yet to really score from a corner. Make these corners count as Liam Jordan puts it in the back post.
Some serious confusion on the touchline. No marks waiting to come on. Mukasi knows he's the man that's being withdrawn and actually walked off of the field before realizing he hadn't been subbed yet. He's back on. He's about to receive the ball, in fact.
Perhaps his last real run. Spots the run of Lechaba. As we did mention, Spu Mahlangu was the man to have been hauled off at halftime. Letsi Kwapeng placing him as the focal point of Amapagania's attack. Augusto Palacios not done. Since rather still wants to shuffle his pack and find that winning formula. Sisu Mabangwa has done well in the early few minutes of this game. Himself and Marcus Slick. In fact, the back four of Bedwes Wits have done well to shackle and close the spaces and give really half chances and cut off the supply for London Pirates. As clever looking ball from Liam Jordan to find Keegan Jacobs. Khanyamane, man who conceded the penalty. It sees us at 1-0 at this stage. Two of the clever boys. Man, it just came in. Neil Marks or Moses Mukasi. Neil Marks, quite a similar player to Mukasi. Horses for courses, I guess. An opportunity now for London Pirates. It's the man Amigo Memela. It's been dynamic, but hasn't had that final piece of quality. That shot, that killer ball. It's been making a lot of runs. It's gone through a lot of work in the attacking third. A bit for Bitvers Wits. Now, Lebo Senso powering from the midfield. Binding Letsi Kwapeng, who decides to turn back. Move eventually fizzles out there. Leo Marks, an opportunity to isolate his man. Pirates players couldn't find each other and they're not on the same wavelength there.
Marks looks up for it. He's one of those players that sometimes he can come on and change a game. And on other days, it just doesn't go his way. Well, remains to be seen which kind of day this is going to be for Neo Marks.
Neo Marks, the 19-year-old, former Randburg FC member as well. You are right. It's quite difficult to tell which Neo Marks will rock up. Amigo Memela, if Letsi Kwapeng was able to just flick it on, was in business. Now Keegan Jacobs in space, toe pokes it, trying to find a teammate. The ball options in the box. Now here come Pirates with Lebo Senso from the midfield. Transition play, Amigo Memela with the ball at his feet. There's a clever little reverse pass, but not too clever for the skipper for Bitvers Wits, Marcus Lackey. Lebo Senso granted. The second half has seen a lot of the ball. Perhaps a clear mandate from his coach to get us playing, get us forward with those powerful drive, running drives from him, from the midfield.
Well, they certainly need to change something, but it's looked a lot better from Pirate, it has to be said. And here, purposeful run. Brought down by Keegan Jacobs, and a real opportunity for Orlando Pirates to make something happen here.
Mukhanyamela, as well as Marcus Slacky, the two men to get yellow cards in this game. Other than that, it's been a clean affair. Machafa and Senso. That is just Senso now. Machafa. Seemed like a handball there. Keegan Jacobs' hand in an unnatural position. Now that would have been something if Riffy had awarded foul there. But close to the box. Fans at home would have had a lot of debating to do. But it is why we love the beautiful game. No one man's opinion is better than the other. Neo marks now. Nicely down to going the inside of his man. Cutting back and still looking for options. The crowd definitely enjoyed that one. Mkhonza. An absolutely wayward pass and kills the move.
That's incredibly disappointing there. That touch from Noah Marks was exceptional. Just brought it down into his own path, ran onto it, beat the man in an instant, and was fouled. Good advantage played by the referee, but eventually the pass inside, the square pass inside, and then the move broke down.
Now Marks, we did mention, sublime at times, and other times anonymous. Never quite sure what you're going to get with Neo Marks. Nonetheless, a talented young man, 19-year-old, still has a lot of football in his legs. I'm sure he'll be looking to improve his football IQ as the years go on.
That's a problem that we lament time and time again in the MDC, but perhaps because as a consequence of these players being young, they are prone to a little bit of inconsistency, and that's often the difference, the reason that separates them from some of their older counterparts. Might be just as talented in terms of their general play, but don't possess that ability to produce it week in and week out.
Another instance of production. Neo Marks again skinning his man, the left back Moriani. The looks of it is Mose. Siabulela Mose earning the third yellow card of the game. Absolutely been skinned not once but twice by Neo Marks.
Siya Mose with a yellow card there. It means that two out of the four in the back line for Bidvest Wits are actually currently on cautions now. And with that being said, they'll need to be cautious.
Definitely would need to be cautious. Twala there battling with his man. Panyamani. Screen. Keegan Jacobs seems to have been taking some strife. Does not look happy at all. Just fell by himself. Yes. He's about to get some attention. Paul Tolo. Seeing to that man. Keegan Jacobs has had a decent game, a very good game. Perhaps but in the shadows of Liam Jordan, himself and Luciano van Heerden clearly sitting and protecting that back four and allowing the likes of Liam Jordan and Mangoba Mnisi. The London Pirates faithful, not sure if they'll be keen and happy with what's transpiring here. The tension perhaps already starting to switch to the big game this afternoon. The Soweto Derby. Chiefs are entering that game off the back of a rather deflating defeat in Absa Premiership and are in desperate need of a win. Now more than ever, some might say. We'll get back to Pirates' form heading into the derby. And the Sea Robbers, well, we've already seen in some serious danger of ending their proud record of the top eight finishers in the league. A 1-0 loss to Jomo Cosmos, the sixth of this season, leaving the club in 11th place. Pressure, Grant, is a word that comes to mind. Eric Tinkler, Steve Compella, pressure.
Well, whilst they were competing in Africa, they had a number of games in hand, so the table kind of belied what we thought they were capable of. But now that they've made up a number of those games, it's become apparent to us that this just isn't Orlando Pirates' season in the top flight. They are 11th, as you mentioned, but more worrying is the fact that they are 17 points off the top, an almost insurmountable gap. They won't be able to get anywhere near the likes of Sundowns, Wits, and Aces.
Sensor there with an opportunity. Orlando Pirates have come into this game a bit now. In the second half, that is. In the first half, they were on the front foot. Did have a lot of the ball. Yes. Clear indication through the possession stats. Seems, Grant, it's a clear tactic from Glenn Salmon to sit back a bit and hit Pirates on the counter. Haven't done really much of the playing in the second half, have bits. Lovely little skill, little dummy there from Neil Marks. As Lechaba spotted the run from Letikwa Ping. Pirates are back at it. Neil Marks seems he's feeling it today. Overdoing it in that instance. Good to see, man. Neil Marks is a confidence player. Kamo Lechaba, the 19-year-old, the former Swallows development player. He's a good player, consistent player at left back for Amaparania. Talking about left back, he's vacated that space. Now an opportunity for Mangoba Mnisi. Nothing comes of it. Referee Luyolo Mchezu. Just play on Mangoba Mnisi. He's calling for a foul there as Letikwa Peng. Skip there from Senso. An opportunity for Mamela. Teases his man. And then tries a second time that reverse to the pass. Perhaps outsmarted himself in the end.
Well, I assume a call had come to prompt that little skip there. Should have been expecting the ball to come upon him and should certainly have headed first time. The ball rolled across the face of goal. And it's the perfect opportunity to just let the ball do the work, really.
Well, we have seen pieces of disky flavor, a bit of style from the London Pirates players, but style is nothing without substance.
When we speak of substance, we mean goals. And the London Pirates are really, really struggling in that regard.
Let's see, Kopenin clearly in an offside position. I wonder, regardless of where Orlando Pirates end up in MDC 2015-16, I wonder would it be Coach Augusto Palacios, the Peruvian's post-mortem of the season, how it's gone for him when he sits back in his rocking chair, or in his living room, wherever he may be, and he thinks, this has been our season, where can we go from here?
Does Palacios strike you as a rocking chair kind of guy? But you're absolutely right, especially after last season and how well they did. You know, we'll come back to that point because a sub is about to take place. It is, of course, Orlando Pirates' third sub, which means they've used all of their available options.
It's that man, Grant Peters.
Well, if his first name's anything to go by, he's going to do fantastically now.
John Peters, the man to replace Amigo Mamela. He's had a very good game, really. Being the liveliest, the brightest spark for the team in black. Nonetheless, hauled off by Augusto Palacios. I would say 12 of his most productive players in the first half. Okasi and Memela find themselves now on the bench. An opportunity for Grant Peters and Neil Marks, the man who've replaced them, to prove the coach right. As Roger Machafa, the skipper, battles on with Keegan Jacobs. Lebo Santo. Lose it over. Crossbar.
Second time, similar position, similar shape on the shot, similar outcome, well over the bar. Going back to that point we were making about when Augusto Palacio sits back, when he assesses the season, what will he think? Well, those affiliated with Orlando Pirates, and certainly those as part of the coaching setup, were, I wouldn't say upset, but in terms of the format last season, where it was two pools and then knockout stages, Orlando Pirates did incredibly well in the league stage as it is.
And get back to the point, sorry there. Great work by Kamuli Chaba to shut down an attack from Manqoba Mnisi.
Then in the league stage, as I was saying, they did really well and fell foul to the knockout stages of the competition. So they would have been amongst the teams, not necessarily campaigning, but very happy when the format changed. But they haven't done particularly well in the area that they were so good in last season, showing their consistency.
Consistency, Grant, and perhaps the chopping and changing of the team, the likes of Menzi Masuku 1 week coming in, Mukwera the other week coming in. Never really seemed to have a settled team. Roger Machafa. Options for Roger Machafa. Neil Marks. Pace. Neil Marks cuts one shot. What a save. Mabanjwa spreads himself and makes himself big. Great pace shown there by Neil Marks. Spotted by Machafa. Neil Marks purposeful. Mabanjwa not to be beaten.
Scintillating run here from Marks, does really well, just keeps cutting inside, and then it's a blistering shot and it's a jaw-dropping save from such close range.
Perhaps a bit too straight at the keeper, either side of him. That's a goal.
Saw the whites of his eyes, he said, not today, son.
Roger Machafa take two now. What can his left foot produce? Straight into the arms of a great from Mabanjwa. Not sure about his kicking technique there from the back. You often see keepers using more of a slice than anything. Rather full on contact, i.e. Itumele Nkune. Now, Manqoba Mnisi with an opportunity to get Vitz on the front foot. We haven't set that in a while. An interesting looking heel. That heeler, as eccentric as his hairstyle there, Grant. Manqoba Mnisi. He has been productive, that the right winger for Wits. Alongside Cesar Twala, we haven't mentioned a lot of in the second half. Perhaps Glenn Salmon might be looking at him. Quick glance down. None of the Wits subs are warming up at this point. Not needed. They are still winning. Just over an hour worth of play being transpired. If you've just walked in, London Pirates are still chasing this game as Mkwanza spots a run from the man who just came in, Grant Peters. Pirates looking for the answers. Fits thus far really playing within themselves in the second half, getting a goal early in the 15th minute to set themselves, set the stall and play the type of game that they want and dictate proceedings. Often now relying on the counter, while Pirates ahead on the possession stats, trying to be on the front foot as Roger Machafa tries his own version of a heeler. Povono being rushed by the onrushing Liam Jordan. Vono was looking for Grant Peters. And Grant, we did mention the post-mortem for the London Pirates. What do you think Glenn Salmon, the former striker, may think of his Chargers season as far? Oh. Foul there on Sizwe Twala. But they've gone, I'll go as far as saying they've gone unnoticed, quietly going about their business in the season. As I said, consistent but not spectacular by any means.
Rather, they are in the top half. I think we are sitting up, we are taking notice. And you're absolutely right. They've just slowly been plugging away, existed for a long period in the mid-table, never really in danger of falling into the lower reaches of the league table. And now they'll look to push on, get a few more positive results, and have a very strong finish to the season.
Liam Jordan there. Great run, missed by Keegan Jacobs, completely missed by him. The Pirates defense had switched on. Nonetheless, Grant Peters, an opportunity to move from defense to attack. Keegan Jacobs there from that free kick. Perhaps still apologizing to Liam Jordan. He just ghosted into the Pirates defense. Nobody saw him. The burglar in the night. And now Marks laying it off to Mkonza. Was looking for the run of Letsi Kwapeng. Grant, look how many players from Orlando Pirates have pushed into the half of Bidwest Wits. Whole team almost in the half of Amaparaniya.
Well, they really, really need to go for it now. And that is illustrated by the fact that they've made all three of their subs. Straying offside there for the seventh time. They were also another illustration of how eager they are to get forward, to find that equalizing goal. But with 20 minutes to go, coming back to that point on the subs, if anything were to happen, it would be very difficult to get back into this.
71 odd minutes on the clock. Was that early signs of throwing the kitchen sink at it? Jordan again with another good run. That time, Luciano van Heerden missing his run as Cesar Tyler as well to bring the ball down, battling away, but judged to have conceded a foul there.
Well, they are throwing the kitchen sink at it. Speaking of sinking, will this be a case of just rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic, or will it have some kind of material consequence? That remains to be seen. We've got just under 20 minutes for that question to be answered. Will it all be for naught, though?
See, Robbers needing a lifeline of some sort. Liam Jordan with a cleverly disguised pass for testing the pace of Mangoba Mnisi. He's continued his battle with Kamule Chaba. 19-year-old left back from Soweto's finest, Liam Jordan. Confident young man.
He gave himself an awful lot of work to do there. Played it on the inside and then had to make up 2 or 3 meters on Lachaba. Did relatively well, but was never ever going to get there in time.
Perhaps I should have said overconfidence.
Perhaps with the game that he's having, he can afford to be a little overconfident.
Leo Marks now spots Roger Machafa. Lays it back to Leo Marks. And one option. The man who's got the ball now, Letsi Kwapeng! Did well to fashion some space from an unlikely position. Sneaked in, stole the ball from the defender's feet and eventually got a curler in. Not on target though.
Really poor attempted clearance from Mabunga with his thigh that presented that opportunity there. And for about the fourth or fifth time, we see a shot from Orlando Pirates fly over the bar.
Mabunga would not be best pleased if he were to give a gift to Orlando Pirates outfit an opportunity back into this game. Give him a sniff of a chance. They are coming off a back of a win. finally did get the taste of winning, the sensation that comes with winning. After beating, getting the business done last weekend. Funny enough, Grant in the reverse fixture. Bits ran out 2-1 winners. That was in November of 2014. If things rather stay as is, London Pirates will be sick of the sight of Bidvest Wits.
Well, that was one of only two losses that they incurred in last season's MDC.
Great skill there from Nisi. Puts a dangerous looking ball. Nothing dangerous about that finish. Nisi, the right back. We spoke about that hairstyle. We spoke about his skill, his pace. Did ever so well to Skinner's opposing defender. That instance, Kamole Chaba had no answers. It's been a great battle to watch between the right winger from Wits and the left back from Orlando Pirates, Kamole Chaba versus Mangwabe Mnisi. It's quite even, I would say, honors even. Some work there for Filippo Vono. The second there, it looked like he's going to find himself in a bit of trouble. Well played there by Letikua Peng, who had done well to chest and turn all in one movement.
Vono almost another hairy moment. It seemed to happen to him against Bidvest Wits.
Jim Macha for the man who was on shot there. They'll be looking towards his leadership. They need something, a confidence booster of some sort, a moment that'll set the cat amongst the pigeons. As Letsi Kwapeng is well ushered in, marked by Merkel Sleki. Kwapeng has done well since coming on, provided an option. Quite a similar player to Mahlangu, truth be told. Mahlangu was getting through a lot of work, running the channels, chesting the ball. Perhaps what's different is Letsi Kwapeng is a better target man, holds the ball better than Mahlangu and gets other players into positions.
Well, the substitutes haven't yielded a goal yet, but they've been very positive. Kwapeng, and especially Neo Marks, he's had a good day, has hardly put a foot wrong, had that excellent run about 10 minutes ago. And they need to keep getting him onto the ball.
Mbamnisi losing out. Brave header there. That's what's on the line. Players do not mind getting injured for the cause. That man Siso Mabanga flying into that header. 3 points are at stake. Good little neat turn from Grant Peters. Perhaps the Israel first moment of quality in this game since coming on for Amigo Memela in the second half. Pirates with players in the box. Lebo Senso. Kwiteng. Letsi Kwapeng, I beg your pardon. Machafa on his less favored right foot. Was clear, was trying to get it back on that wicked left foot of his, in the end earns his team a corner. Marcus Lecky, the skipper, doing his defensive duties. Roger Machafa with a corner. Pirates are dominating in the corner stakes, but have yet to really drive home the advantage. Lovely piece of skill again. That man, Neo Marks, against Mangwabe Mnisi, giving him a taste of his own medicine.
A yellow card for that man, Mnisi rather. Looked busy in the beginning of the first half, dialed down a little bit. Twala, who looked good in the first half, well, he's hardly had a sniff. A couple of interceptions, a couple of tackles, but nothing really material in terms of attacking play, as we saw in the opening stanza.
An issue of tackles. Vitz, according to the stats, the more physical of the two. To mention a good point, Sizwe Twala, Mangoba Mnisi, their influence on this game hasn't been the same in the second half. The subject of influence, Lebo Senso, hard running in the midfield, really upped his work rate, really upped his game in the second half, getting in more attacking positions in comparison to the first half, but he hasn't really been able to work his magic. An opportunity for Katane, another man who we've barely mentioned in the second half. Petvesvets did mention perhaps because they're leading, rather choosing to offer a counter-attacking style of play. Be more defensive and allow Pirates more of the ball, as you can tell by the stats there. Majority of the attacking has been happening in the Vets third. Punching tackle there from Keegan Jacobs, who takes man and ball. We play on. Liam Jordan in all sorts of space if you to pick him up. He finds Katane. See with that jog, he seems to have run out of steam.
We still haven't seen a sub from Bidvest, but one is imminent.
Lovely turn from Luciano van Heerden. Gives it to Mangoba Mnisi. He's been quite prominent on the senior side.
So Bulu will be entering the fray shortly. The rest of the subs are warming up behind the Orlando Pirates goal. A man that I thought we might see come onto the field, in Santuana. Towering, powerful figure. And an attacking player, but someone who could certainly help out with the defensive duties if they needed him to do so.
Luciano van Heerden. Franz Mangoba Mnisi, who looks up. Liam Jordan says, I'm available. Quickly snuffed out by Mkhanya Man, who's done well not to concede any further fouls after being booked very early on in the game. He's done well to keep his discipline. Right, Roger Machafa looking for options. Movement for him in the form of Letikwa Peng. Shot! Goal! My word! Nonchalantly pulled the trigger. He found the back of the net. Ntsali, an absolute spectacular fashion. Pirates found that lifeline we were talking about, Grant. Game on.
Well, they don't score much, but when they do score, they are usually crackers. Oh my goodness, shut the front door. Orlando Pirates are right back in this.
There was a the right back for Orlando Pirates there, Grant. Taking an absolute cracker with his left foot. Where did that come from?
I'll tell you where, Timber. Right out of the top drawer.
Top drawer, Grant. Doesn't get better than that. We have seen similar strikes of absolute beauty from Mukasi. Katane says, I'm coming back. Well defended there by Orlando Pirates, who I'm sure would not like to concede so early after being found an equalizer. Katane. Come on. Grant, we've often criticized this Orlando Pirates outfit, this young Orlando Pirates outfit, of being mentally brittle, not having that fire in the belly to fight back under extreme adversity. But they found a way in a spectacular fashion. What a way to shut up your doubters. Liam Jordan lining this free kick up. Some serious intent. Cristiano Ronaldo style by the looks of it. Now can he have the same impact as CR7? The answer is no.
Sheepish smile on the face of Liam Jordan. He's done it before. Did it on the opening day of the 2015-2016 MDC season, looking to add to the three goals he already has. Scored a 90th minute winner last time out.
He's a man for the big occasion, a man for the drama. Khanyamani getting, he's on a yellow card. Careful there. Nice piece of skill there. Nice piece of footwork. Footwork, should I rather say. From his piece of Mabanga. A second, they're showing that central defenders also have a trick or two up their sleeve. Not just the likes of Neil Marks and Mangoba Mnisi, the man who's just been subbed for Wits.
Sometimes we tend to forget the really good work that the 18-year-old Mabanga puts in. Often overshadowed a little by Lekki. He's slightly more dominant in the air, so you tend to see a lot more of him, especially if the other team is attacking. But with the ball at feet, Mabanga certainly very competent. And an excellent defender for someone so young.
Good football. I put him along the line. The likes of Coutinho and Matisha, who's not with us anymore in terms of from an MDC perspective. Sort of defenders that like to play from the back are so comfortable on the ball and often not given opportunity for their teams to start attacks from the back ever so well and ever so swiftly. Narrow Marks cannot find his man. But man, we just spoke about Sisu Mabanga showing his other side of his game, his reading of the game. In that instance, as Narrow Marks looks to find Letsikwa Peng. Twala being hassled and harried, fighting on. Roger Machafa, he seems hungry. He seems to have found that fire in his belly. Bit too much fire for the referee.
The Orlando Pirates players not really complaining about that, but a lot of dissent shown from the fans. They weren't happy with that foul being called.
In for jersey number 14, Liam Jordan.
And off comes Liam Jordan, replacing him as a man I suggest that they might want to bring on to the field. Vincent Duane, the towering figure of Vincent Duane. You'll see him immediately here in the box as Wits have a set piece opportunity.
Immediate target has to be that man, Vincent Duane. Oh, Lekki is lurking in the back post, but great hands from Filipe Ovona, commanding his box and setting Pirates on the counter. Cynical foul there from Marcus Lekki. Would be lucky to escape a yellow card there. In fact, he's already in a yellow card. Referee saying no more, you're off.
It's one of those ones, if he hadn't had a yellow already, he certainly would have been getting one. But the ref reluctant to make such a big decision that could possibly have such a big impact on the remaining minutes.
Nothing subtle about that one, Grant. Good old fashioned barge. Right, less than a minute of normal time remaining. This game evenly poised and at a knife edge, if I may say so. Who's going to have the killer blow, the knockout punch? London Pirates, are they hungry of the two? Fitness Bits have led for much of the game. Netfield a bit down if they were to not gotten. Came out of nowhere. Absolutely likes Letsikua Peng to take a shot from acute angles, but he does well to find spaces and manufacture these shots out of nothing.
Was an excellent pass from Roger Majafa to just pick him out, and then a neat little touch from Kua Peng. Controls it, brings it under a spell, and then not able to replicate his heroics from earlier in the half when he powered it into the top corner.
Now Grant, is it going to be the clever boys who find a solution to outsmart their opponents today? 2 minutes of referee optional time added on. It's been an interesting finish into this game. As often as it happens in MDC, late drama. A lot of late goals that absolutely leave you in stunned silence. As Esfiso Mabanga is put under pressure, finds Cesar Tyler. Lovely little cushion there. Still showing a bit of work rate. Haven't been running for much of this game. Channels, midfield, it's been everywhere. As the ball is on the pitch. Eking out even more seconds from the game. Now, that's an opportunity for them. Luciano Van Heerden, I beg your pardon. Couldn't find what he was looking for. The left back, the right back for Nando Pirates, Mukanyamani, finding himself an attacking third. Grant Ditmesh did mention throwing the kitchen sink at it. I think it has begun.
Well, there is a chance for them here. I was wondering whether those subs would be for nothing, but it was a substitute that brought them right back into this game.
No marks now with two players for company. Clearly fouls Cesar Twala. Vets have been more aggressive of the two. The subject of fouls. Don't know how much time is left for Mtsundwana, the big man. And they really utilize him and get him in a position where they can profit and land that knockout blow, Grant. Time is certainly run out. Not much left, I do believe. As referee Loyolo Mjezu also one of the Pirates players there.
Well, on the balance of play, you would think that perhaps this is a fair reflection of the game. Orlando Pirates have had slightly more opportunities, but they were chasing the game from the first quarter of an hour. And perhaps the goal for Bidvest came under fortuitous circumstances, slightly controversial circumstances, but they had been the better side up until that point. So, a point apiece. In all likelihood, will be the outcome here. A good result for either team will either be happy or both have expected to have won this.
Fair result, Grant. After this, do not go away. It's the derby. Orlando Pirates versus Kaizer Chiefs. That's at 2:30 on your World of Champions in Super Sport 4 and Select. Oh boy, it's going to be a crack up. Back to this game now. Referee Luyolo Mjezu calls it quits. As my fellow commentator Grant Bissett did mention, a flair reflection perhaps. The scoreline 1-1. Pirates toiled and ran in the heat of PE. That man Mtsali finding an absolute peach of a goal out of nowhere to level Orlando Pirates. Get them back in this game. Did not have enough steam to knock out Bidvest Wits, who then by then being more defensive, haven't really been creating too many opportunities since the turn of the hour mark. That man Filipe Ovono, you feel aggrieved about that penalty decision. Alas, in the end Bidvest Wits won, Orlando Pirates won. Charlie and Jordan showing that the points are shared. midfield. As most games are won and lost, Keegan Jacobs, Luciano van Heerden against Mkhonza. And the likes of Letikua Ping. Possession stats, Pirates were on the front foot. In the end, just shading in terms of chance creation and shots on target. But Vitz more defensive in the second half. Hence the areas we see there. Petvesvets on the right-hand side. Mangobi Mnisi had a blistering game. On the left-hand side, Sizwe Twala wasn't as good. In the midfield, Pirates absolutely dominating in terms of the second half. The Petvesvets, the clever boys, were to get an early-sighted goal. More than an early-sighted, a penalty. Luyolong Jesu saying, Mukhanyamane had fouled Muriene, the left back from Vitz. That was quite early on, 15 minutes. Liam Jordan stood up, the confident Liam Jordan. Vono with the save, but wasn't enough. Ball fortuitously coming back to Liam Jordan, and he said, thank you very much.
Well, they managed to hold that lead into the halftime break, but in the second half, it was Orlando Pirates who pushed for the equalizer, and they found it in stunning fashion. Had some wind in their sails, and this one sailed into the top corner.
Even at second time of looking, it's still a stunner. For me, one of the goals of the weekend.
Goals of the season, potentially.
That man entirely. Definitely be telling his friends and family to be watching replays. An absolute stand up. Mabanja stunned. Could not believe his luck. Could not believe that shot. Came out of nowhere. That was to level things. 1-1. Given space. Given time. What a goal. Watched that the whole day. Can see the crowd absolutely loved that. They have got goals. They have been treated the feast of football here. Well done to the fans. Apipayo for coming out. We'll see you tomorrow again. NBC action continues.
That's the story here at the Wolfson Stadium. It ends. The Clever Boys won. Orlando Pirates won. Liam Jordan of Bidvest joins us now. He walks away with the man of the match. Presenting the award is Zolani, a Bloemfontein Celtic supporter. Zolani? Thank you, Zolani. Liam, congratulations on your man of the match award. Two goals in two matches.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's important for a player that's trying to get into the PSL squad to be scoring goals and goals win your games. So I'm happy to be able to provide goals for my team to get us the points, because we've been lacking points in the last couple of games. So to be able to contribute to that, it's important for the team mainly, yeah.
You kicked off 2016 with a bang.
Yeah, I mean, every year you want to, you know, look to improve, you want to get better, because you're only as good as your last game. So I'm just happy to provide for the team and make a name for myself at the same time.
Thank you. Good luck going forward.
Thank you very much.
That is Liam Jordan of the Clever Boys scoring the first goal there for his side. Joining me right now is Glenn Salmon of the Clever Boys. Coach, still unbeaten in 2016.
Yeah, that's a bit frustrating. I don't mind that fact, but yeah, to get a, you lose the 2 points, it's a bit frustrating, but I will take it, yeah.
Disappointed that you conceded a late goal?
Yeah, it was a little bit late, but I mean, a fantastic goal, so what can you do? You know, we thought we did well up till then, but yeah, so is football.
There's three matches remaining in the league. Are you happy with your team's performance?
Yeah, I think, you know, it's about the individuals performing and obviously showing what they can do to press into the PSL team. So, yeah, all in all, they've done well. Like I say, same old thing. You don't want to concede goals, but it's a learning curve, and that's what we want for them.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks, yes.
Glenn Salmon there of the Clever Boys is happy with his team's performance after match day 12 of the Multi-Choice Disky Challenge. Augusto Palacios of Orlando Pirates joins us now. Coach, are you pleased with the results?
Not really. Not really, because especially the second half, we had too many clear chances. Obviously, you're not shooting, you cannot score. We had one shoot and we scored almost in the end of the game, 5 minutes to go. I think we continue in the practice. We continue, we believe that we in the correct track with some of the new players in the development, also the player for the first team who get the game time. But I'm happy because today we displayed, we consider one goal of penalties. We keep in tight the marking in the second half and we be more aggressive.
How would you sum up your season after 12 matches?
Repeat again?
How would you sum up your season after 12 rounds of the competition?
I think the more important is to see which players is in the level to go to the first team, because this tournament is not about to see which player he can improve, you know, which player we believe is in the level to play in the first team. And we have in the correct track because we identify some players who always, after the first team, technical team and technical committee need to decide. But I'm happy because we majority of the players are the 23, only the players from the senior team, and we keep again time. This is more important.
Coach, thank you. Good luck going forward.
Thank you to you.
That's Orlando Pirates coach Augusto Palacios there, picking up their fourth draw of the season. Of course, they take on Jomo Cosmos before they meet Amakhosi in the big derby on the second week of February in KZN. Stay tuned to your World of Champions tomorrow. There's two matches coming to you live from the Wolfson Stadium. SuperSport United up against Jomo Cosmos and Chippa United up against Amakhosi. That game is live at 12 p.m. live and in brilliant HD on your World of Champions. Of course, want to know what you guys think. So, of course, do join your World of Champions tomorrow as we bring you all the action. And up next, this big Soweto derby is coming up on your World of Champions. Chan 2016 is also still on. And the big Soweto derby, Orlando Pirates up against Kaizer Chiefs. And later, Maritzburg United hosting the Log Leaders, Mamelodi Sundowns. That game is live on SuperSport 4, live and in brilliant HD. From the entire team here at the Wolfson Stadium in PE, thank you so much for joining us. Do join us tomorrow. And myself, Lindy Redube, thank you so much for joining us. Talk to us on social media. Continue with the conversation. But for us, it's goodbye for now.